Dear students, today we will study the subject demography. In this, we will study the size of population, its composition, and its spatial pattern. We study the total size of population and its various features. In composition, we study gender-wise, age-wise, occupation-wise, even literacy-wise, and many other features, and how different regions has different size of population, that is also studied. In all these three aspects, we study in the long run, over a period of time, how does population changes, and it is seen that fertility, mortality, immigration and emigration are the reasons. So population at time t depends upon original population in time 0, that may be previous year or previous decade, plus number of birth minus number of deaths, plus immigration, people who come inside the region or country, and emigration is deducted, people who go out of the region or out of the country. So these are the factors that determine a population of a region. And it has been found that population growth is exponential. As we see in terms of finances, there is a increase in finances at compound growth of rate, which is generally calculated quarterly after 3 months. So its growth is after 3 months. But in case of population, it increases every second. So we have to use an exponential formula. And for that, there is an equation given in statistics books. Pt equal to P0 e raised to the power RT, that is for calculating population growth. Every second population increases. Even now when I am speaking, there is increase in population. So we will study the theory of Malthus, which is the first theory on population. The main argument given by Malthus was that population grows exponentially. It grows very fast, but the growth of food supply is linear or in arithmetic progression. So it increases less than the growth of population. In terms of number, exponential means 1, 2, 4, 8, 12. In terms of arithmetic progression, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, if we don't check the population, finally it will overgrow the resources because food supply is growing slowly. So, there is need for check in population. This argument was based on certain assumptions given by Malthus. First is desire to reproduce by human being remains stable. It doesn't increase over time. Standard of living and population growth is positively related. As we become rich, we tend to increase our population. And third, there is a diminishing return in agriculture. So food supply doesn't increase at faster rate. It increases at diminishing rate. Malthus talks about two types of checks on population. One is preventive, another is positive. Preventive checks basically lowers the birth rate. That means Preventive checks can be morally, you don't produce more children, you don't marry, or you control birth by taking certain steps. So preventive checks is considered good. It increases work effort, and other checks which Malthus talks about is positive checks. It increases death rate, whereas preventive lowers the birth rate to reduce population growth, but positive checks increases death rate to lower the population growth. Positive checks may be miseries, famine, disease. These are positive checks, and because production of food grain is, or supply of food grain is growing at slower rate, population growing at higher rate, so there will be miseries, there will be disease, and there may be famines, and due to these factors population can be controlled. So this is a pessimistic idea of population control. There are certain criticisms of Malthus theory. First is historically wrong. In history, when we go back, then it has been seen in most of the region that production of resources, output, goods and services has increased manifold and faster than population growth. He ignores the role of technical progress. Technologically, it is possible to increase agriculture production manifold. Then there is a possibility of controlling population by family planning. So it is not that population will grow in geometric progression. But in certain region, population theory given by Malthus is correct, especially in poor countries where production of food grains have not increased much, but there is a increase in population. So there is a overpopulation and there is a stress on resources. So we cannot say Malthus theory is wrong. Finally, we can conclude that Malthus has given two important points in his theory. One is controlling population is essential to enhance economic welfare. We must control population through preventive checks. If we fail to control through preventive checks, then positive checks in terms of miseries, disease, and famine, population will be controlled to equilibrium level. Another aspect, he has explained that there can be a problem of overpopulation, which we are seeing in South Asia and many underdeveloped countries. So Malthus theory has these positive outcomes. We will study other theory in the next lecture. Thank you.